57. Albuquerque Journal, Something to Crow About, 2015年7月12日 John Olmsted Source, Albuquerque Journal, NM July 12, Zion, Orphan Court Foo Dog, a golden silky rooster, has new ticks in corrals, named for his resemblance to the Chinese lion figurines that guard entrances. Foo Dog and two hens will have separate, but adjoining friends, because they don't always get along, says owner Paul Rodenhauser, a longtime chicken enthusiast. Although more respondents in the Backyard Chickens website poll kept chickens for eggs, Rodenhauser, a professor emeritus from Tulane University, tips his sub-chickens as pets. It's a sad story. I grew up isolated with no playmates, so I bonded with chickens, he says. He decided after he retired he would have his own flock again. He also paints chickens and other birds, favoring wild chickens, red jungle fowl, that the progenitors of all domestic chickens. He says, I think they are beautiful. His flock includes four multicolored Seremas, a tiny breed from Malaysia, a chocolate bantam English Orpington and golden Dutch bantams. They range freely several times a day. Most have low enclosed groups around his courtyard, but Foo Dog's converted shed was about 1,500 baht build and incorporated covered enclosures from village mercantile in corrals. The elaborate group is more than most chickens call home. Most of the groups at village mercantile range from 1,000 baht to 1,000 baht, says Rob Ingram, general manager, who has seven chickens in his backyard. Ingram says his store has sold 18 more baby chicks this year than last, growing hobby more and more people in the metro area wake to softly clucking hens, finding value in the eggs they lay and the company they provide. Forbes magazine attributes the national trend to the green movement, urban gardening and a desire to eat locally sourced food. Albuquerque ordinances allow residences sub chickens and one rooster, but some communities have covenants or ordinances that exclude them. Ingram's associate Katra Hedrick, who gave up her growing flock after a move, says she had chickens, ducks and two turkeys. They were more pets. The eggs were boners. Each breed of chicken has a different personality. She likes social Orpingtons because they will cuddle, but also likes Americanas for their blue and green eggs. Most breeds can be touched and held, if they are handled as chicks, says Andrew Bu, one of the store's owners. He's had all kinds of livestock including chickens for as long as he can remember. Raising chickens makes better people, he says. Kids who raise animals turn out to be kinder humans in the end. No local threat production chicken farms are suffering from avian flu in the Midwest, playing havoc with commercial egg production. But the New Mexico Department of Game and Fish says the state has only had one confirmed case of the disease, a wild duck at Basque del Apache. Sick wildfowl can infect domestic birds if they come in contract, but says it would be difficult for backyard chickens to become infected, especially if they live in a covered group. Predators like coyotes, owls, raccoons and skunks pose the greatest danger to chickens here. He says, lining the lower edge of the group or cage with fine mesh fencing helps keep them safe. Careful attention to group cleanliness helps keep chickens healthy. Burr says chicken manure is a great addition to gardens. Most people buy chicks in the spring so they can match an interlaying hens by September. But Ingram says he's still selling the babies and adopting out pullets and roosters that need homes. After they start laying, chickens lay eggs for about 2 to 4 years and many lay an egg a day, except when it's cold. When laying may slow, hens don't need roosters to lay eggs, but need them to lay fertile eggs that could hatch a chick. Burr says he and his family ate the chickens when they quit laying, although some of his customers keep them as pets. Few requirements: chicks need a clean, enclosed pen, warmed to about gauss up degrees, and about a square foot of space each, according to the New Mexico State University Extension Service. When they start to get feathers, temperatures can be reduced. They need about 2 to 3 feet of space as they become adults, but that can vary if they get to roam, or free range. around the backyard. The extension service recommends buying feed for chicks or chickens labeled complete and providing plenty of fresh drinking water. Harry Johns, who keeps sublock chickens on his property in the Carrolls Park, says the chickens only need an hour or so of attention a day. He gets about 8 eggs a day and gives most of them away. He loves his chickens that he's kept for about 3 years, but he doesn't name them. I don't think it's good to name them. It's too personal, and if a crinoid or something gets them, it makes it harder. Poultry pageant. The Village Mercantile in Carrolls will host a judged chicken show at the Carrolls Harvest Festival the last weekend of September. Copyright C. Yeetinlingyesupn, The Albuquerque Journal, Albuquerque, N.M. Visit The Albuquerque Journal, Albuquerque, N.M. at www.apicjournal.com. Distributed by Tribune Content Agency, LLC.